we at University of Chicago are trying to find the science behind strategy. There are two primary ways people study strategy or leadership. One is eminence-based, the other is evidence-based. Eminence-based would be, so Steve Jobs is a famous strategist, what did he do? Mark Zuckerberg has been very successful, what did he do? And it's useful to see these patterns and what they've done, but what's the limit with studying the life of Steve Jobs? I'm not Steve Jobs, and my history is different than his. So I have to be careful about just emulating slavishly, but that's eminence-based. Evidence-based says, what are the skills, techniques that can be measured that are true to all good strategists? One thing we know is they're usually very good at negotiating. They're better at predicting in their industry than others. Can we measure that? And at Booth, because we're such a quant school, we're trying to measure the things that lead to success. And we're doing a lot of research into the psychology of decision making. And we've really been a key pioneer in the field of behavioral strategy. My colleague Jim Schrager and Al Medansky have been leading this charge for a long time. It's become easier with the rise of people like Dick Thaler and Danny Kahneman as they've plowed and gotten Nobels for behavioral psychology as such, behavioral economics as such. But we're trying to think about this narrow set of the leader making strategic decisions. How do experts formulate strategy in a generic way? Not how did one person do it, but how does it work across all human beings and cultures? And how do we decide what to do? You'll have to come to the school. We have a great course on advanced strategy program, building and implementing the growth strategy. It's week-long, only costs $10,000 per person. And it's a great thing about teaching at a business school. You can sell just shamelessly. So we would love to have you come and spend more of your dollars to learn how to think better. But that's all I can give you is that little teaser ad. So I'll give you a quick definition of strategy, though, that comes out of the behavioral science approach. Strategy is the decision we make. It's not the output. It's the decision we make in the present based on learning from the past about how to grow or defend in the future. So it's really all about decisions. And do we make our decisions well? How do we improve the quality of our decisions to grow and defend our business? Strategists need to consider the various scenarios. A fabulous way to think about it is a win scenario. You know, outside success. Run in number of those scenarios. What leads to outside success? Then do something that Gary Klein, a fabulous decision researcher, but non-academic, he's a field researcher, says he calls it a pre-mortem. He says, examine in advance all the ways you can fail and think what will cause us to fail. So do a success scenario plan, do a pre-mortem scenario plan, and then Steve Johnson in his, I think it's his latest book, Farsighted, talks about doing a weird scenario plan. Like something, it just seems so improbable, but run it. So to give you an example of that, the newspapers would have done, this is how we continue to grow our empire through consolidation of our markets and stuff like that. How are we likely to fail? We're not going to execute well enough and a competitor is going to take us. What they never dreamed of was the three people that would take their business away. The three people that took their business away, Craig Newmark, well, it was four people, Craig Newmark, Mark Zuckerberg, Larry Page, Sergey Brin. And when they started their businesses, they weren't thinking about newspapers. You know, Craig Newmark of Craigslist, he was just trying to find friends when he moved to the West Coast. Mark Zuckerberg was doing what every college kid's ever want to do, is just find a friend, so to speak. And Larry Page and Sergey Brin were glorified librarians doing page ranking of academic citation. When they started out, it's a weird scenario. So you've got to look and say, you know, what's the scenario where we win? What's the scenario where we lose? Let's do some weird scenarios and then just see the most logical move, the highest probability way to win. Do you see the most logical move? Take a moment for yourself and write down. It's good if you write it. Don't show it to people. One big goal for your life or work. Get it in mind. you know what strategy will help you attain the goal? If you see the right move. So the goal is where you want to go. The strategy is how you're going to get there. If you can't see your strategy, why not? Is it because you're new to the space, or is it because your space has been disrupted? What data is going to help you make your decisions?